Hello and welcome to the Caymanas Park Highlight Show. In this week's edition, we recap select races on the cards from Saturday, October 5 and Sunday, October 6. 18 races were contested over the 2 days, with all eyes geared towards the Jockeys' Championship race, as the island's top two jocks, Tevin Foster and Radish Roman, were both tied on 99 wins going into the weekend. Saturday's main feature was the 51st running of the Philip Fiani Gold Cup, a win, and you're into the cash-rich Moutet Mile, scheduled for December 7th, while Sunday's feature event was a Vassal Jollyman Najir Memorial Trophy. We begin our highlights with race number 2 from Saturday.
They're off and racing. Shaboom steps a bit slowly but recovers right away and leaves Nala's Bushman to trail. So it's Power of Faith passing the 7 with that lead from Shaboom, coupling up nicely. Then comes Pro Johnny as they head toward the 6. It's Power of Faith from Shaboom. Then comes Pro Johnny. Premier Identity comes next. Just behind Premier Identity, that's Princess Talisi, and recovering already, that's Nala's Bushman. They head toward the 5, and it is Power of Faith in front and stretching that lead about 5 lengths in front and looks intent, maybe more too. Power of Faith slipping down into it now. That is Nala's Bushman. Shaboom is watching them from third. Then comes Pro Johnny as they pass the 4 furlong point. Right beside Pro Johnny, that's Premier Identity. And still racing at the back of the field, that's Princess Talisi. It is Power of Faith on about a 6 length lead and looking good. Here comes on the outside now and beginning to go down into it. That's Shaboom. It's Power of Faith looking to be tiring from Shaboom, going down and attacking. Power of Faith still in front. Shaboom watch on the inside and coming on. That is a Premier Identity. Power of Faith still in front. Premier Identity trying to get to Power of Faith. Also coming on the wide outside. That is Princess Talisi. Princess Talisi now begins to come forward. Power of Faith tying up from Princess Talisi. That hits the front. It's Princess Talisi in front. Power of Faith is still there too. But Princess Talisi begins to pull away from these. Princess Talisi going on to win for Dane Dawkins. Princess Talisi wins from, it looks to be second. That is Lawless Bushman. Then comes Premier Identity and Power of Faith back and forth.
Princess Talisi gets the job done as a 3-2 favorite in the Orient Express. Dane Dawkins riding it for Turner Laundry Mantle and owner Emmett Hines. Live ticket count at Vegas 6, 1,607, with over 6 million in that net pool, and 166 tickets are going on the Kits 9. It's time for the Distinctly Irish 2007 winner of the Gold.
Azera. And Dream Warrior gets rid of the rider early, so Dream Warrior out of the race. On Captured Empress, racing widest of them all, takes a commanding lead early. Princess Akila now asked to cut into it as they lead the 7. 4 or 5 lengths back to Cosmic Force, Sweet Victory racing down against the fence as they make their way now toward the 6. Captain Philip on the outside of Sweet Victory and Dimitri P now trails narrowly. They've left the 6 and run toward the 5 on Captured Empress out in front by a length and a tail. Princess Akila racing in second close up. Cosmic Force is 3.5 lengths back and running in third in the slop as they leave the 5. A break of some 4 lengths back to Sweet Victory. Dimitri P a length and a tail back and Captain Philip struggling at the back of the field. They're approaching the final half of a mile. They're about to go into the bend for home. An uncaptured Empress out in front, but pressed now by Cosmic Force in the pink. Dimitri P has slipped neatly down into thirds. Sweet Victory racing on the outside of Princess Akila, and Captain Philip remains last. They leave the 3 behind them as the tempo will increase, and the favorite uncaptured Empress still holds the lead by about 2 lengths. Sweet Victory is the one now running the rail and cutting the corner as uncaptured Empress will bring them into the top of the lane with that lead. Toward the outside, Dimitri P and Victor Sanchez. They drive now inside the final 16th. It is uncaptured Empress out in front. Sweet Victory chasing with Dimitri. But this uncaptured Empress is enjoying the slop, leaves the furlong pole with what looks to be an unstoppable advantage inside the final 16. It's all uncaptured Empress, the favorite, winning the way. A favorite should Radish Roman has his second win on the card. They win by maybe 6. Sweet Victory is second, Dimitri P third. Cosmic Force is fourth.
Richard Empress delivers in the Distinctly Irish, and that's the fourth consecutive outing that I've tipped on Captured Empress to win. She was second two of the last three. And I said to you earlier today, if she doesn't win today, it's the end of me and her in terms of tipping her to win. And she wins, so we're all smiles on Captured Empress gets the job done. The 2-5 favorite make it all the running in this sloppy going there and gives Radish Roman his second win on the card. Sweet Victory completes the exacta. That's a Radish Roman, Tevin Foster exacta, $309. Still good money for the top two jocks in the land right now. And in third was Dimitri P with Victor Sanchez. So Radish Roman gets the better of Tevin Foster and Victor Sanchez, the trifecta there.
Be ready. Ready for a start. The rough and racing. Randy misses it a bit and is left at the back of the field. Irish Wish goes for that lead. Along with Shanita Extra, there goes Gelroy. Radam is out wide and Tiffany Blue. About four lengths before we come to Seaplane. Then comes Noble Sovereign. The Soul Warrior comes next and Randy left at the back of the field. They head towards the three. And it is Irish Wish in front. Just the leader from Tiffany Blue tracking intently. Irish Wish now goes on about three lengths. Gelroy slipping down into second. Tiffany Blue is right there in third. Radam comes next. A four lengths away before we come to Shanita Estrella. And the rest are out of it. They're at the top of the lane. Irish Wish still in front. Bring them into the lane. Here comes Gelroy right against the rail. Tiffany Blue is asked for more. But it's Irish Wish slipping away from Gelroy. Tiffany Blue. On the inside, that's Shanita Estrella. Radam left flat-footed, but Irish Wish begins to come away from these. Coming to the half of furlong pole, it's Irish Wish and Terrific Tevin Foster. That's three on the day. Terrific Tevin Foster sprinting clear and maybe by five lengths. Tiffany Blue is second. Then comes Shanita Estrella, Gelroy, and the Soul Warrior back in fifth.
So race number six, yeah, I'm satisfied. Went to Irish Wish, the favorite, a little bit of the second favorite, Tiffany Blue. Third was Shanita Estrella. Fourth was Gelroy. The numbers I gave you there for race number six were 6, 8, 3, and 7. And that's a bullseye, bang on target for the numbers. The exacta return 206, the quinella return 256, trifecta 164, and the superfecta $276. So the numbers came through perfectly there. According to calculations in the sixth event, live ticket count on the catch nine stands at 7, make that 11. With 783,000 plus in the net pool. It's now time for the late triple.
Play Fair comes out at the back. Allegiance races wide with Firecracker. Come home to me in between horses. Impressive Force is the one in the red down against the fence. Run, Julie, Run is moved by them all. And the speedy Run, Julie, Run gets that lead. Impressive Force just about three parts of a length down and a racing in second. Come home to me, taken off the fractions, some five lengths off that lead as they leave the six. Firecracker runs the rail. Allegiance races out three wide. Further back to Blue Sensation and Play Fair just at the back. We're about to arrive at the five. The riders slowing it down and Run Julie Run. They lead now by three parts of a length as Firecracker gets closer. Allegiance on the outside in a handy spot with Impressive Force going to save ground as they go into that turn, running right on the rail as they leave the half mile. Come Home to Me has several lengths to make up along with Blue Sensation and the Play Fair remains at the back. Run, Julie, Run out in front. By now, some two lengths. Allegiance making a big move on the outside. Impressive Forces right there. Sanguijin between them. That's Firecracker. Come Home to Me needs to find six lengths. Then Blue Sensation and Playfair remaining at the back as they're going to come thundering into the top of the lane. They're into it now. And the filly, Run, Julie, Run. She was second in the derby. And she's asked to go. And now she begins to come away from them. Impressive Force, the foreigner, is asked to kick in on the outside. But Run, Julie, Run, the grey, is out in front and not showing any signs of stopping. A 16th remaining, it's Run, Julie, Run in another impressive performance. Rayan Lewis and Run, Julie, Run, romp it by maybe five. Impressive Force, big run in second. Come Home to Me is third. It's a head bob. could be Blue Sensation over Allegiant.
Their King is Born and Buzz Nightmare went to the Flying Filly run, Julie Rum. Classy filly indeed, won the 1,000 guineas this year, third in the St. Leger, second in the Jamaica Derby. And she shows rivals a clean pair of heels today on a sloppy track. So another grey wins on the slop. Run Judy Run made all the running, or most of the running at least, and won in 1:38 and a fifth of a second. Good time for a mile, and she scored by 4.5 lengths. Impressive force, chased relentlessly from the top of the lane, and this was a big step for him today, up against classy rivals, but he lost a few marks in defeat. Top weight, 57 kilos, and his second by 4.5 lengths, and in turn was 9.25 lengths clear of the second runner-up. Come Home to Me. 10 tickets are live on the Catch 9, 783,000.
We're set for a start. They're off and racing. Not a bad line, as Solo Black is right up there along with Immeasurable Joy. So it's Immeasurable Joy that leads from Supremacy. So make that train of thought right there too. About two lengths before we come to Adira. Then comes Fearless Force hunting up a space. Also there, that Small Boss. On the inside of Small Boss goes West Young Man as they pass the five. Then comes a First Offense. First Grandson and racing at the back of the field of Solo Black. They head toward the four, and it is Supremacy on that lead, bouncing about a length and a half in front of Immeasurable Joy racing in second. Then comes Train of Thought right there in fourth. That is a Fearless Force. They're coming to the three, and it is Supremacy still in front from Immeasurable Joy pressing in a challenge. Also there, that's a Fearless Force. Train of Thought comes next. Small Boss is out wide. They're at the top of the lane, and it is Supremacy still in front on the outside now. That's Immeasurable Joy right against the rail. Fearless Force, it's a good-looking finish. It's still in front and traveling. It's Supremacy still in front. Fearless Force trying to get to Supremacy. So it's Stevin Foster and Radish Roman fighting this one out. But it is Supremacy getting the upper hand, and Supremacy goes on. And it's four on the day for Terrific Stevin Foster, beating Fearless Soul into second. Then comes Immeasurable Joy, got tight for fourth. Could either be Train of Thought or Adira.
It's now time for the 51st running of the Filippiano D Gold Cup. And on your monitor right now is a photo of the great Filippiano D, 14-time champion trainer at Caymanas Park, 1981, 1982, 1989, 1991 to 1998, the year 2000, the year 2001, and 2004. Champion breeder as part owner of Hamstables Limited as well. And Filippiano D is a Hall of Fame inductee, recipient of the Nonsuch Award, Guinness Book of World Record Holders most classic wins, and he has saddled 2,128 winners up to October 4th, 2024. That's, of course, up to yesterday. Five Triple Crown winners. Some of his outstanding horses were Kaz O'Shea, Prince Consort, Luchi Poo, the Viceroy, Vestia, Eros, Temperance Oaks, Chi Min, Wanting and Having, I'm Satisfied, A King is Born, Distinctly Irish, Princess Popstar, Classique, Simply Magic, Milligram, and Exceptional Type. We honor the living legend, Filippiano D, with the Filippiano D Gold Cup. Scratch number one, Desert of Malibu. Just forget that though. How about Tevin Foster and Radish Roman? They've been riding up a storm all day long. Six wins between them. Four from Tevin and two from Radish. And today, Radish Roman found the lead for the first time all season when he won race one at Sensational Satin, and he followed up with a double with Uncaptured Empress. But Tevin Foster has had an immediate answer with a four-timer of his own. So he's now back in front. And indeed, we look forward to the Tevin Foster, Radish Roman show to continue. And we have nine more races tomorrow. And clearly, they're going to be doing their best for the rest of the season. It's now on to our feature. We'll be right back.
start already. They're off for the Gold Cup. Atlantic Convoy misses it just by a shade as they go tearing down the back stretch. As expected, Wall Street Trader has speed. There goes Banadura rushing down on the outside, and Banadura grabs it from Wall Street Trader. Fun Can done right in behind them. Toward the outside, Major Danger is there. Norblar has improved a place. Is That a Fact has faded back through the field ahead of Atlantic Convoy and further and beyond. And last of all, interesting times ahead as they make their way now toward the half mile and the turn for home. Banadura, just the leader. Wall Street Trader a length down and racing next. Fun Can done begins up. Big move on the outside. Major Danger is only four lengths off that lead. Further and beyond races up next with interesting times ahead as they go charging away now, leaving the three and come toward the 5/16th. It's Fun Can done who now assumes that lead. Wall Street Trader left some three lengths back, but coming into the top of the lane. And it is Fun Can done out in front from Wall Street Trader. The rest all trying to close up further and beyond is racing up in the center, but it is Fun Can done having them off their legs at the moment. Is That a Fact now unleashed and asked to close the gap on his stablemate? It is Fun Can done by 2.5 lengths. They're inside the final 16. Fun Can done hanging on. Is That a Fact now beginning to close with every stride, but Fun Can done wins the Gold Cup over Is That a Fact, then Further and Beyond, Atlantic Convoy, and Major Danger.
Time for a break now on the Caymanas Park Highlights Show, and when we return, we'll continue our highlights from this Sunday, October 6th race card. Welcome back to the Caymanas Park Highlights Show. We continue with select races from this Sunday card, picking up at race number one.
They're off and racing. Whisper to Me left at the back of the field early, as Right on the Rail Crushing Power is right there too, rushing down on the outside. That's Excuse Me Goodbye. So Excuse Me Goodbye from Galloway Bay. Then comes Racing in a third. That's Where You're On. A Racing fourth. That's Crushing Power. Then comes Estelita. Behind that one, we find Fiery Path, and still at the back of the field, that's Whisper to Me. They go towards the 2.5 furlong point, and it's Excuse Me Goodbye on a three-length lead from Galloway Bay, racing in second. Where Your Honor is third. Right there in fourth, that is Crushing Power there at the top of the lane. Furlong and a half to travel. Excuse Me Goodbye still with that lead, easily leading it about two or three lengths in front of Galloway Bay, hustled up onto the left-hand stick, running on for third. That is Where Your Honor, but it is still Excuse Me Goodbye. And Terrific Tevin Foster leading them, a merry dance in the first. Excuse Me Goodbye is sprinting away from them, and Excuse Me Goodbye and Terrific Tevin Foster winning the first. Where Your Honor runs on to be second. Galloway Bay is third, and Fiery Path back in fourth.
So the first event won by the favorite Excuse Me Goodbye, and that's Tevin Foster on the 104th winner for the season in a row there for trainer Fitzroy Trade Richard. Excuse Me Goodbye, no longer a maiden. That one made most of the running. Where Your Honor completed the exact turned 182. The Quinella Plus is almost 220 in dividends here, and the Trifecta 172, Superfecta 134. So the numbers I gave you 584 and 2, and the race came back 854 and 2. We'll be right back.
They're off and racing. Catawba gets a good start to the near side. Right there, too, that's Phoenix Risen in the mix. Over on the far side, Stormacum. And way over on that far rail, that's John P. So Phoenix Risen looks to just be the overall lead from Catawba right there. Also there, that's Stormacum. Over on the far side, John P. is there prompting the pace. Then comes Unruly Boss and Little Grovy Thing left out of it. They make their way out of the chute and come on to the racetrack proper. Phoenix Risen and Catawba. This is where the race is at the moment. Phoenix Risen looks to have the overall lead. Catawba is hard at work in second right there and coming on. Here comes Unruly Boss down the middle. Phoenix Risen still in front. Unruly Boss begins to take aim on Phoenix Risen. It's still Phoenix Risen. Unruly Boss hustling up and coming forward. Phoenix Risen. Unruly Boss grabs a hold of Phoenix Risen. Phoenix Risen not resolute. Phoenix Risen. But Unruly Boss goes on. And Unruly Boss begins to go away from Phoenix Risen. Unruly Boss and Philip Parchment. Well ridden. Beats Phoenix Risen. Then comes a got tight for third. Could either be Little Grovy Thing or Stormacum.
Onward Boss gets a run from off the pace with Jockeys Guild President Philip Parchment of Saturday for Trainer Oral Hayden. And at 3-1, Onward Boss runs down the longtime leader, Phoenix Risen, and gets the job done. Good exact payout there, 754. 1,428 tickets are live on the Regga 6, and we have 174 live tickets on the Catch 9.
Seven furlong the trip, ready for a start from Duane Timmel. They're off right away, and it's a good line. Sicario Mando is left at the back of the field along with Jack Daniel. They blast towards the six furlong point, and Run Georgia Run is doing that. Run Georgia Run is in front of Tequila Flight Racing in second. Cassini slipping down into second. About two lengths or three lengths before we come to Ansatak, right on the rail and hustled up and asked more. That's Jack Daniel. Beside Ansatak, that is a Roaring Thunder as they pass the five. Then comes Sicario Man and Body Move for Company. They head toward the four furlong point, and it is Run Georgia Run, just the leader from Cassini, breathing down the neck. It's Run Georgia Run. Cassini now goes on from Run Georgia Run back into second. Then comes up Jack Daniel. Tequila Flight is improving, also improving. That's Roaring Thunder. Sicario Man comes next, about four lengths before we come to Ansatak, and Body Move is still at the back of the field. It is Cassini and Jack Daniel. These two are fighting for it. They're coming at the top of the lane. Cassini on the inside, Jack Daniel on the outside, worrying Cassini all the time. Cassini still in front, Jack Daniel. Here comes Tequila Flight down the middle too, and now Jack Daniel hits the front. Tequila Flight is bearing down on and Jack Daniel, and now Tequila Flight hits the front end, now beginning to pull away. Tequila Flight is in front at the furlong pole and is skittering away from the field. Tequila Flight is home and dry. O'Shea Nugent, he's on 99 wins. He'll get his 100th win. O'Shea Nugent and Tequila Flight wins. Second, Jack Daniel got tied for third. Could be Sicario Man just over Roaring Thunder. Cassini fading back into fifth.
I'm an upset win there by Tequila Flight with two-time champion apprentice O'Shea Nugent, more popular known as Johnny, achieving a milestone 100th career win. So it seems as if 100 is the lucky number this weekend. Yesterday we had Radish Roman and Tevin Foster achieving 100 wins on the season, and they've both surpassed 100 wins for the season. And now we have O'Shea Nugent achieving 100 wins in his career. So lucky number 100. Congratulations, O'Shea Nugent, on your milestone victory aboard Tequila Flight in upset fashion too at 9-1 and won by some 14.25 lead. So that's a big way to make 100 in your career any day.
Under a downpour. Ready for a start for Michael Sims. They're off and racing. Missing it, that's Fighter Jet and Ruby's Light. Rushing to take that lead, that's a Plum and Himaya. right on the outside that she's adorable, right against the rail. That's another mission. Shelly the Rocket is just in front of another mission, right against the rail. That's Monster Vigorous. Then comes Queen Vaughna, five lengths away before we come to Secret Mission. Then comes Ruby's Light, and racing at the back of the field, that's a Fighter Jet. They're passing the four and making the running a plum. A plum just on that lead from She's Adorable, tracking in second. Imaya is racing two lengths away in the third. Then comes Shelly the Rocket. Behind that one, that's Monster Vigorous, now overtaken by Queen Vaughna, and another mission hunting up a space. They're coming at the 2.5 furlong point, and it is still a plum. And right there on the outside, it's She's Adorable now. It's the front, it's She's Adorable in front. Imaya trying to stay with She's Adorable, but She's Adorable is in front. Imaya trying to get back to She's Adorable, but She's Adorable is kicking this mud at Imaya. But She's Adorable in front and traveling nicely, splashing, split splashing all the way to victory. She's Adorable is on recall, about 4, 5, maybe 6 lengths. She's Adorable beats Imaya. Racing in third, that's another mission. Then comes Queen Vaughna and Shelly the Rocket back in fifth.
She's Adorable proves to be the right choice here in race number 6. Radish Robot riding for Turner Carlton Cunningham. And after finishing third out of the last 3 outings, where the runner-up in each race came back on one, as she duly obliges as the short price favorite here. Second went to Himaya, another exacta there for Radish Robot and Tevin Foster. The exacta returned 151. The Quinella Plus is a must, $214 in dividends. That now puts Radish Robot to 102 on the season. And Tevin Foster, of course, is on 104.
They're off and racing. Caught them in a beautiful line as a breath of fresh air wants that lead. So to a Prince Aman. So Prince Aman and a breath of fresh air right there too. That's undisclosed location as they go past the four. Just behind them, that's Battle Angel and the Miracle Angel left at the back of the field. Prince Aman, about a half a length in front of a breath of fresh air, right hugging the rail on the inside. Then comes a Battle Angel circling runners on the behind that one. That is a undisclosed location and racing at the back of the field, the Miracle Angel. They're at the top of the lane, and Prince Aman is let go by the rider. Prince Aman skipping away by 3 lengths. Here comes undisclosed location, begins to chase relentlessly, but it's Prince Aman still in front and traveling nicely. Undisclosed location still chasing, but he'll have to find about 5 lengths as Prince Aman begins to sprint away from these. And Prince Aman and Omar Walker land this one by about 5 lengths. Undisclosed location is second. Then comes a breath of fresh air and maybe the Miracle Angel back in fourth.
That's been there by Prince Aman. 6-time champion jockey Omar Walker riding for trainer Anthony Nunes. Anthony Nunes continued his good form from yesterday, had a triple yesterday, and gets a win with Prince Aman. Prince Aman made most of the running in that 5-run contest, clearly enjoyed the sloppy underfoot condition. Second went to undisclosed occasion, his stablemate. Good exact pair there, 289. And the numbers I gave you for race number 7 were 4, 2, 1, and 5. And the race came back 4, 2, 1, and 3. So he got the exact of 289. He got the trifecta of 346. And indeed, that was a good double as well, with She's Adorable winning race 6 and Prince Aman winning race number 7.
This is the 8th. They're off on racing, and Uncle Nub misses it badly and gives the rest a jump as a Baby Love blasts into an early lead, followed on the inside by Princess Ifya, Ertugrul rushing out wide. Then comes Digital Light. Miss Linton comes next. Then comes Kismet, right behind the Kismet. Now recovering, that's Uncle Nub. Then comes on the outside, here comes Doc as they pass the four, and racing at the back of the field marginally, that's Sky on the go. It is Baby Love bouncing easily in the slop, about 2 lengths in front of Ertugrul, hustled up and asked for more. Right against the rail, that's Princess Ifya coming out wide. That and coming on nicely too, that is Uncle Nub, but it is Baby Love bringing them at the top of the lane. Uncle Nub will straighten out wide, it's Baby Love in front and kicking the slop at them. It's Baby Love coming to the furlong and a half pole with a good looking lead and begins to tear away from them. Digital Light is coming on nicely too, but it's Baby Love in front and not for catching today. Digital Light will only be second best, and Baby Love and the Sneaky Fox running away with this one. Digital Light cutting in the margin, but it's gonna be too late. Baby Love sprinting off and sprinting off by five. Digital Light is second, then comes Running On for third. That's Here Comes Doc. Kismet is fourth, and Miss Linton back in fifth.
Good win a while ago by Baby Love, making all the running. Radish Roman there for his apprentice master Anthony Nunes. Completing exactly was Digital Light with Tevin Foster. So we have another Radish Roman and Tevin Foster exactly. They had one earlier, and that was She's Adorable and Himaya. So they're going really great here. The exact return, 278, and that's like money in the bank when you bet on Radish Roman and Tevin Foster. The Quinella Plus is a must, $304, and that's also like money in the safe, so to speak. So great going there, Radish Roman and Tevin Foster. This tally right now, Tevin Foster on 104 and Radish Roman on 103. And we have one race remaining, and that's going to be the feature.
They're off and racing. Big Argument blows a start and is left at the back of the field as Money Market rushes for that lead. Milos is right there too. Digital One going down along with A Gift from Ben. Then comes Whiskey, Joy's Golden and Yellowstone. Just beyond the rail, that is Money Monster. Then comes Princess Sylvia. Going out right and rushing down into it, that's A Perfect Brew. And racing at the back of the field, Big Argument. And racing just behind Big Argument at the back, that is the six horse, Awesome Anthony. They're coming at the top of the lane, and it is Perfect Brew. That bursting to that, it is Make That Money Market on that lead. It's Money Market in front. Digital One coming up the rail. Also coming out wide, that's Perfect Brew. It's Money Market in front and traveling nicer to the furlong pole. Here comes Perfect Brew coming with a challenge, but Money Market is still repelling them. It's Money Market in front and traveling nicely. Money Market, here comes Perfect Brew diving down on Money Market, and Perfect Brew has done it from Money Market. Then come Digital One, Milos, and Money Monster. Back in fifth.
Another thrilling weekend of racing comes to an end with notable performances all around. Radish Roman and Tevin Foster both achieving milestone victories by surpassing the 100 wins mark in a given season. As it stands, they now have 103 and 104 wins in favor of Tevin Foster. Two-time champion apprentice Ocean Nugent also registered his 100th career win on the Sunday card. This has been another edition of the Caymanas Park Highlight Show. See you next time.